Good evening. In our last lecture, we have seen what is AVL tree and if the tree is imbalanced, what are different rules for rotation in the AVL tree. Today, we are going to see one problem on solving or designing the AVL tree. In the examination, there may be a question on designing an AVL tree like this. Design an AVL tree for the following elements. The list of elements are given to you. So how to solve the AVL tree for the given list of elements? We'll start designing the AVL tree like a binary search tree. We pick the first element of the given list and we'll draw it here and we'll make it as a root node of the tree. We have to calculate the balance factor after putting the node into the AVL tree. If the balance factor is in the range of 0, minus 1 and plus 1, then that is in the range of AVL and it is called AVL tree and it is not imbalanced. But if the balance factor of any node is more than 1, then such a tree is called as imbalanced tree. And if there is a imbalance at a particular node, we have to balance that node with the help of the available rules for rotation in AVL tree. Now we insert the next element, that is 34 from the given list, into the tree. 34 is greater than 21, we must place it into the right subtree according to binary search tree rule. So if you recalculate the balance factor here, the balance factor of node 34 is 0. The balance factor of node 21 becomes minus 1 because the balance factor is nothing but the height of left subtree minus height of right subtree. Here there is no left subtree, that's why the height is 0. On the right hand side, there is only one level down. That's why the height of right subtree is 1. So 0 minus 1 is minus 1. Till now, all the nodes are in the range of AVL. That is 0, minus 1 and plus 1 balance factors. Now go on inserting the next element. If it is in the AVL tree, we can insert further elements into the AVL tree till it is balanced. And whenever it becomes imbalanced, we have to apply the rotation rules. Now take the next element, that is 5, and insert it into the AVL tree. 5 is less than 21, so we must place it into left subtree according to the binary search tree rule. So now we again recalculate the balance factor. Balance factor of leaf nodes are 0. Balance factor of 21 is 1 minus 1 is 0. So again it is an AVL tree. There is no problem here. It is balanced tree. Now go on inserting the next element, 70, into the tree. When you insert 70 into the tree, it is greater than 21. It is also greater than 34. So that's why it is placed into the right subtree of 34. Now here if you recalculate the balance factors, the balance factor of node 5 is 0, 70 is 0, 34 is minus 1, 21 is 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. Again all the nodes are, balance factors are in the range of AVL tree. So there is no problem till now. Now insert 18 into the diagram. When we insert 18, it is less than 21. It goes to the left subtree of 21. But it is greater than 5. So it must be placed to the right subtree of node 5 here. Again, we calculate balance factor just for checking whether the tree is balanced or not till this point. So the leaf node are having balance factor 0, 0. Node 5 is having the balance factor minus 1, 34 is having balance factor minus 1, and if you calculate the balance factor of root node 21 here, the left height is 2, 2 levels down here, and right height is also 2, so 2 minus 2 is 0. Again, in this diagram, there is no problem of imbalancing here. All the balance factors are in the range. Insert 55 into the diagram. It goes to the left part of 70 here, and if you calculate balance factors, the leaf node is having balance factor 0, 0, 5 is having minus 1, 70 is having plus 1 balance factor, 34 is having minus 2, 21 is having minus 1. Now, if we see in this diagram, there is an imbalance occurred at node 34 with balance factor minus 2. Its similar children is having plus 1 balance factor. If you see the signs of these two nodes, the signs are opposite. It means that we have to take double rotation. Whenever there are opposite signs, we have to take double rotation. In case of double rotation, we have to balance the child first and then we balance parent. Child is having plus one balance factor. Whenever there is a plus sign, it means we have to take positive right rotation, and whenever there is a negative sign, we have to take left rotation. So it is the concept of right and then left rotation. We will apply that rule and we'll balance this imbalance tree. If you take the right rotation from node 70, 55 goes to the root node and 70 will go to the right part of 55. Again, recalculate balance factors in this diagram. All leaf nodes are having 0, 0 balance factor. 5 is having minus 1, 55 is having minus 1, 34 is having minus 2, and 21 is having minus 1. Now if you see, again there is a problem here. 34 at node 34, it is having minus 2 balance factor, and the children is also having minus. Both the signs are same. Negative balance factor. If there is a negative balance factor, we have to take single left rotation from the node 34 here. If you rotate towards left hand side, the node 34, the diagram will look like this. In this case, 55 will take the place of 34. 34 will go to the left hand side of node 55 and 70 to the right side. Again, we recalculate the balance factors in this diagram. And if you see, all the balance factors are in the range of AVL. So now it is a balanced tree. Previous tree was not a balanced tree. It was imbalanced at node 34 here. Okay. Now this is the correct AVL tree for this diagram. Now we'll pick the next element and we'll try to insert into the diagram from the given list of elements. That is node 65 we want to insert into the diagram. So 65 is greater than 21, greater than 55, less than 70. That's why it goes to the left subtree of node 70. Here we recalculate balance factor. If you see, the balance factor of every node into this diagram is in the range of AVL, that is 0, minus 1 and plus 1. There is no problem. So it is balanced. Go on inserting the further element, that is node 70 into the diagram, 75, sorry, into the diagram. When you insert 75, it goes to the right subtree of node 70. If you recalculate balance factor in this diagram, all leaf nodes are having balance factor 0, 0, 70 is having 0, 55 is having minus 1, this root node is having minus 1, 5 is having minus 1, and again it is in a balanced tree because all the balance factors are in the range. Now try to insert the next element, that is 85 in the diagram. When you insert 85, it goes to the right subtree of 75 because it is greater than all the elements available into the tree here according to the binary search tree rule. Now if we recalculate balance factors in this diagram, all the leaf nodes are having balance factor 0, 75 having balance factor minus 1, 70 is having minus 1, 55 balance factor becomes minus 2, 21 is having balance factor minus 2 again here. Now the tree is imbalanced at 55 first and then 21 later. So we have to balance the tree at node 55 first. If we check the balance factor of node 55, it is minus 2 and its immediate children is having minus 1. So both the signs are same here. It means we have to take only a single left rotation because of negative sign. If it is single left rotation from 55, 70 becomes the root node, 55 goes to the left subtree, then 34 goes to the left subtree of 55, 75 towards right and 85 towards right of 75. What about node 65 in the previous diagram? It is, according to the binary search tree rule, it is greater than 55 but lesser than 70. So if it is less than 70, it must go to the left subtree, but it is greater than 55, it means it must be placed at the right subtree of node 55 here. This is the correct place of node 65 into the tree. So if we recalculate balance factor into this diagram of each and every node, we can see that all the balance factors are in the range of 0, minus 1 and plus 1. It means it is a AVL tree. Now try to insert the next element, that is 46 in the diagram. If we insert 46 here, it goes to the right subtree of 34 according to binary search tree. Okay. Recalculate the balance factors here. All the leaf nodes are having balance factor 0, 0. And if you see, after calculating the balance factors at root node 21, the balance factor is minus 2. Its immediate children having towards right hand side is plus 1. Opposite signs. When there are opposite signs, we have to take double rotation. And in this case, it is the rule of right and left rotation because its immediate children is having plus 1 balance factor. In the case of double rotation, we have to first balance the child and then balance parent. So if you take right rotation here, because of the positive balance factor of node 70, 55 again becomes the root node, 70 will go to the right subtree, 75 to the right, 85 to the right, and left part of 55 remains as it is, that is 34 and 46. The node 65 gets placed to the left hand side of 70 according to the binary search tree rule. It is greater than 55 but less than 70 here. We again recalculate balance factors, and again we came to know that at root node 21, the balance factor is minus 2. Its immediate children is having minus 1. It means both the signs are same, and we have to take now single left rotation from root node 21. After rotating the tree from root node towards left hand side, your tree look like this. 55 takes the place of 21. 21 goes to the left hand side, 5 goes to the left, towards side we have 18, towards right of 55 we have 75, 85, and to the left of 70 we have 65. But what about this part, that is 34 and 46 into this diagram? Where to place it after the single left rotation to this diagram? If we apply the binary search tree rule, it is less than 55 but greater than, all these elements are greater than 21. So both the elements 34 and 46 must be placed to the right subtree of 21 here, that is 34 here and 46 here. So this is the correct AVL tree for the previous diagram. Insert 36 now. If you insert 36, it goes to the left subtree of 46. Again, we calculate the balance factors. So balance factors of leaf nodes are 0, 46 plus 1, 34 minus 2, and 21 minus 1, 5 is minus 1, 70 is minus 1, 75 minus 1, and 55 plus 1. If you see in this diagram, the tree is imbalanced at the node 34, which is having minus 2 balance factors. The immediate children is having plus 1. Opposite signs, we have to take double rotations. Which rule we have to apply here? That is first right and then left. Right left rotation. So we will take a right rotation from 46. If you take right rotation, 36 becomes the root node of 46, and 46 go to the right subtree here. Recalculate the balance factors again. After recalculating the balance factor, this becomes minus 1, this becomes minus 2, and rest of the balance factors are same as the previous diagram. Now if you see at 34, the balance factor is minus 2, its immediate children is having minus 1, signs are same. We have to take single left rotation now from 34. After taking single left rotation from 34, your diagram will look like this. Okay, so now it is balanced tree for the previous diagram. All the balance factors, if you recalculate here, all are in the range of AVL 0, minus 1 and plus 1. Now we will try to insert 26. It takes the left child of node 34. So it will be placed at left side of 34 here. Calculate the balance factors. If you see, all the balance factors are in the range of AVL. There is no problem in this diagram after inserting 26. Now we will try to insert 16 into the diagram. If you insert 16, it goes to the left subtree of 18, and recalculate the balance factor. After recalculating the balance factor, we came to know that the tree is imbalanced at node number 5, which is having minus 2 balance factor here, and the immediate children is having plus 1. It means double rotation scheme. Apply the double rotations scheme here and balance the imbalanced part of this tree. So this is right rotation first, we balance the child first, and then we balance parent node 5. So this is the concept of right and left rotation. If you apply the right rotation from node 18, 16 takes the place of 18 and 18 goes to the right subtree of 16. Again, if you recalculate the balance factor, all the remaining nodes are having the same balance factor as the previous diagram, but the balance factor of node 18 is 0, 16 is minus 1, and 5 becomes minus 2 here. So we need to take single left rotation because the node 5 is minus 2 and node 16 is also having minus 1 balance factor. After rotating this, we'll get the final tree here,